Alright, so hello everyone, my name is TRG, and I'm here to play Wuthering Waves. As you can see here, I already completed the main mission, but I'm planning to complete the other one though. So the further let's play is the gameplay. Lumpy Lumen. Pagumo.
Remnants of the past. An unexpected discovery.
Nice.
Cherish every gain.
Mm-hmm. Yes, a couple of these, so what should I call you? Mm-hmm. Upper floor.
Remnants of the past. Cherish every gain. An unexpected discovery. Cherish every gain. Cherish every gain.
Mm-hmm.
Remnants of the past.
Huh.
your weakness. Cherish every gain. Remnants of the past. Remnants of the past. the sounds.
Here we go again!
Moment of resonance.
Administering first, embracing change.
Swift and resolute. Cherish every gain. Of the past. Cherish every gain. One with the sounds.
Wooly's attack!
Unexpected discovery. remnants of the past. Cherish every gain.
I thought on that section.
Yes. I can feel the tension in the streams. I'm worried something bad is gonna happen.
There you are, Rover!
Remember to check your terminal signals and wear the Academy's protective suit correctly. And don't forget to stay hydrated. Now, I have experiments to run. The Academy has noted a concerning rise in tacit field activities. Please use caution when exiting the city.
It's just Bija being Bija. She's a little awkward with showing care, but I think it's cute. Anyway, Rover, quick, tell us what happened. The Frax at us again? Ugh, those jerks!
Jian the General, Jin Si the Magistrate, and Yue, the Jinjo Sentinel. Is there any kind of connection between them?
Connection? No idea. But I did hear General Jian used to be a military doctor.
Speaking of that, I think we'll need to start with a bit of Jinjo's past. A storyteller near the theater once told us something like this.
The Honorable Madame Jin Si, our great magistrate of Jinjo, was handpicked by Sentinel Jur. Her status as the Sentinel's appointed resonator is rare among all past magistrates. Our Jinjo was leaderless for years until Jur finally chose her to be the next magistrate, and she answered the call. To further elaborate, we must start with the battle beneath the crescent. The Norfall Barons, scarred by countless wars, discarded weapons scattered like bones. Our soldiers had fought to reclaim the land for years, to no avail. Overthrax, the dreadful Threnodian monster, fed on the frequencies of weapons, turning our fallen soldiers into deadly tacit discords. General of the Midnight Rangers, Geshu Lin, bravely rose to confront the threat. As Twin Moons aligned, General Geshu Lin vowed to vanquish evil, raising his blade against the blood-red crescent that foretold destruction. His sword blazed with black flames, laying waste to all who dared stand in his way. Victory seemed certain. Until the retroact rain began to fall. Raindrops fell upwards as in the past. Monsters raged. Loyal souls fell to blood-soaked sands. Infernal carnage! Issuing his last command, Geshu Lin demanded all soldiers stand firm, no matter what happened. Sacrificing his body to the black flames for power, Geshu Lin charged at the Overthrax with all his might. And he was never seen again. After the fall of their leader, the remaining soldiers despaired until the deafening roar of Qin Long struck like lightning. A lone youth bravely stood up to lead a hard-won retreat. After the battle, that young man who tamed the wind ascended to fame, becoming the new general of the Midnight Rangers, selected by Sentinel Jur. On the other hand, General Geshu was blamed for the massive losses that occurred under his command, earning him a notorious reputation in Huanlong. That battle struck us hard, but our sentinel rose from its long slumber to select a new magistrate who will guide us into the future. Despite the previous disaster, Jinjo was off to a promising start under our sentinel and the new magistrate's guidance. The people held hope for a better tomorrow.
Whoa! First time hearing about all that. Maybe the Sentinel had its own special ways of picking candidates. Or maybe it is their incomprehensible ways that set these divine beings apart from us. Their thinking tends to be elusive to the average person.
Yeah, true. Wouldn't be surprised if Jue decided to make me the magistrate one day. Not gonna lie.
I understand your concern, Rover. Madame Jinshi was only a teenager, and she was suddenly selected to be the magistrate. It must have been so difficult for her. I remember people were skeptical when she first took office. Despite her achievements, many believed she lacked the necessary experience and authority in the political realm. People only showed their respect to Madame Jinshi because they trusted Jue's judgment.
Seriously, Lord Jue knows how to choose him. Our previous magistrates were all top-notch at running the show. And Madame Jinshi, she's already made the city a well-oiled machine in no time. I'd have a mental overclock just trying to keep up with all that paperwork. She was made for this. But what is that saying again? Real gold never loses its shine.
Rover, since you were asking about this, did you get clues from your past from Madame Jinshi? They sent two overseers at once. Their scheme must be far more expansive than we thought, though the Fraxidas do seem to know a lot about you. Their ideology and actions are too dangerous, and right now, the odds are in their favor. If we rush into a confrontation, it could lead us into their traps. Rover, since you were asking about they sent two though the and right Rover. Since you were asking about this.
The Norfolk Barons? It's been a battlefield since ancient times.
Rover, it's dangerous there. The Norfolk Barons is the front line in our defense against the Thranodian. We must be careful about going there. Rover, since you were asking about this.
The Black Shores? Doesn't ring a bell. Sounds like the name of a place, but I've never seen it on any map.
This flower. It's only a photo, and I can't tell where it came from with my ability. We're still in the dark about Fraxida's plans, and the Norfolk Barons is too risky. The Black Shores seems to be our only option now, but if we are to look for them with only a photo of this flower, it's going to be difficult.
Since it's about flowers, we should go ask Grandma Lin.
Yes, Grandma Lin runs a flower shop. I'm sure she can give us some tips.
You're making me blush a little. Grandma Lin loves listening to storytellers. I think I saw her earlier. Let's go look for her.
Thank you.